Yeah, that's a problem. Being in an environment where the majority of your experiences are fucking adverse and you're working to produce or be productive for self at the same time. When understanding the adverse experiences, especially when they come in the form of other people's shit, other people's intentional attempts at their own personal gain and sustenance at your expense. And that's one type of adverse experience. That's human intentional trauma. Then you have the adverse experiences such that, you know, weather, environmental, things like that. And then you do have the true accidental shit that happens. Yet they are all they are indicative of adverse experiences, shit that get in the way and slow down progress, personal progress, and gain. As a result of my existence in a very highly adverse situation and situations, is my reality and what others hear as or have labeled as my excuse for the current position that I am in. And that position includes the current behaviors that I display. That's what it is. So extremely sort of painful to me. Adversity and adverse experiences by nature and by default and as intended is designed to cause harm. It is designed to disable a person's forward movement and productivity for themselves. And in its place is somebody's shit that is directing your energy away from you and to them, feeding them. We kind of like know that this is sort of real, that this shit happens because it's reported on a daily basis in so many ways. Social media outlets where it's reported how people have actively, it's like, look at the war. Wars in the world are designed to direct people's energy and attention towards the needs and desires of the warring factor, the one who initiated it and or who called for it and or who supports it. And whoever they declare war on, the person or persons that, you know, those person or persons are now needing to stop what they're doing to direct their attention to this motherfucker who has declared war on them. And they direct it away from their own shit and their own selves and what they were doing based on who they are and why they were doing it. That's a very big, broad, global look at this process. It can also be viewed I think that I am going to leave this pizza crust in the freezer for a little bit while my sauce is working its way to be ready. Think about, I see my behaviors, I see myself, and then I begin to talk about what the hell I see. Think for myself and begin to work and plan. Yeah. What triggered this about the environment? I was working to cook and I looked at my cherry tomatoes that I grew, cherry tomatoes that I produced and harvested, and the cherry tomatoes that harvested it are going bad. A little bowl full of them. They're going bad. So, shit, why the hell didn't I eat them yet? Well, when I think about, you know, that thought, why the hell didn't I eat them yet, triggered and opened the door for a view of my world very quickly in terms of what I was doing instead of eating them. I envisioned the environment that would have supported me eating them, where I can see myself actually eating it. But it's like before you really get a full picture of okay, I'm eating them, I produce my shit and I'm eating them, and this is what I'm doing with it because this is what I intended. It's like fucking reality crashes in and all the other shit in your current world begins to show itself, and it shows you what is fucking getting in the way of me doing this thing that I envisioned. And what came up for me, it looks like it's tomatoes, and it's like, you know, my world expanded and I begin to see my family, the situation, the thoughts, the behaviors, how it impacts me, what it means to me, you know. Environment holds the key to a lot. And I don't know if I'm going to really be able to eat this. Fucking, this is this roll. This is going to be messy. I can see that. We might as well take some stuff with us because this is going to be messy. It's not going to be flatbread stuff. And I did not put anything. This is not the best thing for drinking out of. Shit, it's cluttered. I'm in a cluttered environment with cluttered minds and clutteredness. And I envision to be in a space that's uncluttered. And when I envision an uncluttered space, that space is a space that is just me and my shit and not family members and nobody else lives there. I live in and I see the environment that I want for myself. To have that where I was, where I'm at, blah, 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 and this is a never fucking ending story. And people say, well, just stop thinking about it and begin to think about it and begin to do what you envision. Okay, I did. All right. So going out in the work world, interview with these fucking right crack ass women and this mental health system that is, I am not hired. Create your own job. Nobody can pay for it. Give me enough. And no one wants what I have to offer. It's usually people help. Link up with somebody. Community. When attempts are made to do that, and attempts have been made, ask me what I have done before you just say, oh, you need to. I did that shit. And this is what happened. What do you think about that? Oh, that's just an excuse. Oh, okay. I just told you what the fuck happened. If you had asked me what happened, I would tell you what happened, and then you say what happened was an excuse. The fucking reality is what's fucking happened. What do you want? No? What people want is a reality that fits. They want your reality to fit with their beliefs. And when your reality does not fit with their beliefs, then they say that your reality is an excuse. That's how I think it happens, and that's how I think it goes. And probably not the best way to communicate. I'll just leave it real raw and it's